Chapter 49. I'm coming, too. Turning her head, High Firmament found that it was Celestial Lotus. Where are you going, sister? I'm going with you all to West Chi. They had barely started off when someone called again. Wait for me, sisters. They found it was Lady Pretty Cloud. The latter bowed. I see you are on your way to West Chi. I met Shen Gongbao, and he invited me to go there and help Brother Wen. How happy I am to meet you all here. Let's go together. The five of them traveled on and reached their destination, Moment Water. At the Sheng camp, they asked the guards to report their arrival to Grand Tutor Wen. The Grand Tutor came out to meet them. When all were seated inside, High Firmament said, My brother Zhao Gongming left Wolfu Cave to help you here. Unfortunately, he was shot by Jiang Ziya. Now we've come to collect his corpse. Would you kindly show us where it is, Grand Tutor? Grand Tutor Wen wept bitterly. Brother Zhao Gongming was unlucky. Before he died, he told me, I regret not taking my sister High Firmament's advice. I've brought about my own downfall. He asked me to put the golden dragon scissors and his robe in a parcel and give it to you so that when you saw it, it would be just like seeing him in person. As he spoke, Grand Tutor Wen broke down, sobbed loudly, and covered his face with one of his sleeves. The five ladies wept with him. Grand Tutor Wen got up from his seat and took out the parcel. Opening it, the three sisters mourned bitterly. Their tears fell like rain. Jade Firmament gnashed her teeth, and Green Firmament flushed with anger. Where's my brother's coffin, sir? Green Firmament asked. It's in the back camp. Grand Tutor Wen replied. Let me go to look at it. Jade Firmament said. Since he's dead, what's the use of looking at his coffin? High Firmament asked. As we're here, why not go and look at it? Green Firmament persisted. The two sisters walked to the back camp, and High Firmament had little choice but to follow them. They took the cover off the coffin and stared at the body of their brother. Seeing that Zhao was still bleeding from the eyes and heart, they could not control their anger. Jade Firmament screamed and nearly fainted. Sister, don't be agitated. We'll catch the murderer and shoot him with three arrows too, to avenge our brother. Green Firmament said furiously. This has nothing to do with Jiang Ziya. It was Lu Ya, as fate had destined. We'll just catch him and shoot him. Then our revenge will be complete. High Firmament put in. The next day, the five ladies left the Shang camp with Grand Tutor Wen and Deng, Xin, Zhang and Tao. High Firmament rode her green phoenix up to the reed pavilion. Tell Lu Ya to come out and meet me, she demanded. When the challenge was passed on to him, Lu Ya got up and said, I'll go straightway. He took his sword and rushed out from the pavilion, his long sleeves billowing in the wind. High Firmament saw that he had the bearing and air of an immortal. She said to her two sisters, He's known as a hermit and is sure to possess some ability. We'll see what he has to say and gauge the true depth of his learning. Lu Ya moved toward them slowly, singing a song. He bowed before High Firmament. Are you Lu Ya? Yes, I am. Why did you shoot my brother, Zhao Gongming? Jade Firmament asked. I'll tell you frankly, if you've got enough patience. Otherwise you may take action as you please. Go on and tell us. High Firmament said. To achieve enlightenment is the only proper path to follow to the way. Immortals are those who follow the proper way. I achieved enlightenment in the epoch of the Heavenly Emperor at the beginning of time, and I've witnessed the enlightenment of many with my own eyes. Only those who act with virtue progress spiritually. Who could have imagined that Zhao Gongming would commit such an error? He sided with a tyrant who disregards the ethical relationships and slaughters the innocent, evoking the wrath of heaven and the resentment of the people. He used his magic without regard for anybody else. Whoever acts against the will of heaven is bound to die, and I was sent by heaven to put him to death. How can I be blamed for it? My friends, Can't you see that this is not the place for you? There are only mountains of weapons and oceans of fire here. How can you survive? If you stay here, I'm afraid you'll lose your chances for everlasting life. I've taken the liberty to speak frankly. I beg your pardon if I've offended you. High Firmament sighed deeply and said nothing, but Jade Firmament screamed. You damned brute. How dare you deceive us with rubbish? You shot my brother and now try to defend yourself with your slick tongue. I guess that your powers are insignificant. What can you do to us? Fuming with rage, she rushed up to slash at Lu Ya with her sword. After several rounds, Green Firmament cast her universe muddling dipper high into the sky. It was such a powerful weapon that before Lu Ya had time to flee, it had caught him and threw him to the ground. Despite his great power, he was almost knocked unconscious. Green Firmament bound him tightly, stuck charms on top of his head, and hung him up on a flagpole. He shot my brother. I'll shoot him in return, she said. 500 archers were summoned immediately, but though the arrows showered like rain, they dropped to the ground without harming him. As each arrow touched his body, it turned to ashes. Everyone was astonished. How can we allow him to fool us like this? Green Firmament screamed and cast up her golden dragon scissors. Sorry. I must be going. Lu Ya shouted. He transformed himself into a rainbow and disappeared. When he returned to the reed pavilion, Burning Lamp asked him. You were caught by the dipper. How did you get away? They tried to shoot me, but every arrow turned to ashes as soon as it touched my body. When they cast up their golden dragon scissors, I turned into a rainbow and came back here. We all admire your wonderful skill. Burning Lamp said happily. I have to leave here for a while. I'll be back soon. Lu Ya told them and took his leave. The next day, High Firmament went out with her four companions and demanded Jiang Ziya. Jiang Ziya met them with his disciples on his left and right. He bowed down. Greetings, my Taoist friends. Jiang Ziya, cried High Firmament. We're all carefree Taoists living on the Three Fairy Island. We care nothing for the rights and wrongs of this vulgar world. We've come here now only because our brother, Zhao Gongming, was cruelly murdered by your charmed arrows. Why did you put him to death so unjustly? How wicked you are. Though we know you're not the chief culprit, you nevertheless killed him. We cannot but hold you responsible. Your magic powers are too insignificant to be mentioned, and even Burning Lamp wouldn't dare offend us. You're wrong. Jiang Ziya replied. We had done nothing to offend your brother, but he came here to trouble us, bringing disaster on himself. It was his destiny. He disobeyed the orders of his master. Jade Firmament flew into a rage. You murdered him yet make the excuse that it's all destiny. How dare you cheat us with your cunning words? I'll avenge him by giving you a taste of my sword. She urged her swan forward to attack Jiang Ziya, and he defended himself with his sword. Huang Tianhua and Yang Jian joined in. To counter them, Green Firmament, roaring like thunder, flew in on her bird, and High Firmament also had to help her sisters. Pretty Cloud took the eye-blinding pearl from her gourd and knocked Huang Tianhua from his jade unicorn. What became of him? If you want to know, read the next chapter.